I feel nauseous, believe me. Never had a lot of shit come easy. Had to work hard, struggle just to be me.
Let's get indoors. Oh, what is it? We're getting close. I'm sure of it. I've never even seen this part of the castle before. Be careful. I don't know what might be around. Who's there? There. Sure, I heard something. Who's there? Where'd you come from? We're getting close. I'm sure of it. We're getting close. Leave it to my mother. Always smarter than I gave her credit for. Look at this place. This has to be it. I knew she was deep into necromancy. I mean, she taught me everything I know. But I had no idea she had a setup like this. Look at all this. She must have spent years collecting these components. And what's this thing? I'm not sure about this circle, but it's obviously something. Let's take a look around. There has to be something here that tells us where she's gone. My mother was meticulous about her research. If we can find her notes, there might be some hints in there. Not that I ever saw. My mother had a bit of a thing for magical constructs. Not what you're thinking. She just found them fascinating. I had no idea her laboratory even existed. She had an alchemy set up in her drawing room, but nothing that even comes close to what's here. Looking at the equipment and materials, it looks like she was trying to advance her necromancy. I don't know. Certainly not longevity. Kind of a waste of time for a vampire. Remember, she used to keep a small journal. See if you can dig it up. Keep searching for her notes. She probably had a journal or something. Any luck yet? You did? Let me see them. I only know what she told me. She had a theory about soul gems, that the souls inside of them don't just vanish when they're used. They end up in the Soul Cairn. The Soul Cairn is home to very powerful beings. Necromancers send them souls and receive powers of their own in return. My mother spent a lot of time trying to contact them directly, to travel to the Soul Cairn itself. That circle in the center of the room is definitely some type of portal. If I'm reading this right, there's a formula here that should give us safe passage into the Soul Cairn. A handful of soul gem shards, some finely ground bone meal, a good bit of purified void salts. Ah, damn it. We're also going to need a sample of her blood, which, if we could get that, we wouldn't even be trying to do this in the first place. Not bad. We'd better hope that's good enough. Mistakes with these kind of portals can be gruesome. Anyway, enough of that. Let's get started. Oh, definitely. Mother would have plenty of those materials in her laboratory. You just need to find them. Having trouble finding those ingredients? The Soul Cairn is a tiny sliver of Oblivion, the realm of the Daedra. It's ruled by unseen beings known as the Ideal Masters. Honestly, I don't know. Necromancers are always interested in souls, though, so that probably has some kind of interest. They shouldn't be that hard to find. Shelves, tables, they should be easy to find. She wouldn't have hidden them. Having trouble finding those ingredients? 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 Nobody really knows. As far as I've heard, no one's seen them and returned to Tamriel to tell about it. I've read stories. Stories about fools that manage to communicate with them. You give the Ideal Masters souls, they give you powers to summon the undead. It's all very businesslike. Because most of the stories end with the Ideal Masters duping the necromancers, who end up dead or wishing they were dead. They shouldn't be that hard to find. Shelves, tables, they should be easy to find. She wouldn't have hit them. Get the ingredients in that vessel and let me know when you're ready. Then the rest is up to me. Are you ready to go? I'm not entirely sure what this thing is going to do when I add my blood. Of course. What is it? I've been asking myself the same thing since we came back to the castle. She was so sure of what we did to my father. I couldn't help but go along with her. I never thought of the cost. She wasn't always, but I think you're right. She was practically smirking as we left home, almost like she was proud of herself. Like she didn't just want to stop my father, she wanted to stick it to him too. Yes, you're right. I'm sorry. I just didn't expect anyone to care how I felt about her. Thank you. Are we ready then? All right, here goes. Where'd you come from?
You must help me find my Arvak. He doesn't deserve to be in a place like this.
Till next time.
Mother? Mother!
Snake. It can't be.
Serana?
Is it really you? I can't believe it. How do we get inside? We have to talk.
Serana, what are you doing here? Where's your father?
He doesn't know we're here. I don't have time to explain.
I must have failed. Harkon's found a way to decipher the prophecy, hasn't he?
No, you've got it all wrong. We're here to complete the prophecy our way, not his.
Wait a moment. You've brought a stranger here? Have you lost your mind?
No, you don't...
You, come forward. I would speak with you. So how has it come to pass that a vampire of mixed blood is in the company of my daughter? Glorious. Serana claims you're her guardian, yet your first instinct appears to be greed. I see that my daughter is still as naive as ever. Serana has sacrificed everything to prevent Harkon from completing the prophecy. I would have expected her to explain that to you. You think I'd have the audacity to place my own daughter in that tomb for the protection of her Elder Scroll alone? The scrolls are merely a means to an end. The key to the tyranny of the sun is Serana herself. When I fled Castle Volkahar, I fled with two Elder Scrolls. The scroll I presume you found with Serana speaks of Ariel and his arcane weapon, Ariel's bow. The second scroll declares that the blood of Cold Harbor's daughter will blind the eye of the dragon. Like myself, Serana was a human once. We were devout followers of Lord Molag Bal. Tradition dictates the females be offered to Molag Bal on his summoning day. Few survive the ordeal. Those that do emerge as a pure-blooded vampire. We call such confluences the Daughters of Cold Harbor. It was expected of her, just as it was expected of me. Being selected as an offering to Molag Bal is an honor. She wouldn't have dared turn her back on that. It's what some call the domain of Molag Bal, his place in Oblivion. Now you're beginning to see why I wanted to protect Serana, and why I've kept the other Elder Scroll as far from her as possible. If Harkon obtained Ariel's bow, and Serana's blood was used to taint the weapon, the tyranny of the sun would be complete. In his eyes, she'd be dying for the good of all vampires. And how exactly do you plan on completing the prophecy without the death of my daughter? If you believe that, then you're a bigger fool than I originally suspected. Don't you think I weighed that option before I enacted my plans? You care nothing for Serana, or our plight. You see the tyranny of the sun as your chance at deification. And like Harkon, you won't hesitate to destroy anything that stands in your path. Serana? This stranger may call himself a vampire, but he knows nothing of our struggle. Why should I entrust you to him?
This stranger has done more for me in the brief time I've known him than you've done in centuries.
How dare you! I gave up everything I cared about to protect you from that fanatic you call a father!
Yes, he's a fanatic. He's changed. But he's still my father. Why can't you understand how that makes me feel?
Oh, sir. If you'd only open your eyes.
The moment your father discovers your role in the prophecy, that he needs your blood, you'll be in terrible danger.
So to protect me, you decided to shut me away from everything I cared about. You never asked me if hiding me in that tomb was the best course of action. You just expected me to follow you blindly. Both of you were obsessed with your own paths. Your motivations might have been different, but in the end, I'm still just a pawn to you two. I want us to be a family again. But I don't know if we can ever have that. Maybe we don't deserve that kind of happiness. Maybe it isn't for us. But we have to stop him before he goes too far. And to do that, we need the Elder Scroll.
I'm sorry, Serana. I didn't know. I didn't see. I've allowed my hatred of your father to estrange us for too long. Forgive me. If you want the Elder Scroll, it's yours. Your intentions are still somewhat unclear to me. But for Serana's sake, I'll assist you in any way that I can. Yes. I've kept it safely secured here ever since I was imprisoned. Fortunately, you're in a position to breach the barrier that surrounds these ruins. You need to locate the tallest of the rocky spires that surround these ruins. At their bases, the barrier's energy is being drawn from unfortunate souls that have been exiled here. Destroy the keepers that are tending them, and it should bring the barrier down. One more word of warning. There's a dragon that calls itself Durnavir roaming the cairn. Be wary of him. The Ideal Masters have charged him with overseeing the keepers, and will undoubtedly intervene if you're perceived as a threat. Be careful, and keep my daughter safe.